What's going on, guys? Tech81 back here with Field Tech Vlogs. I am very tired. It's a limited staff holiday, so I'm in an hour earlier than usual. About an hour and change. I didn't sleep that much last night, but usually in these cases, limited staff holidays are trouble calls. That doesn't mean we won't be running any new drops or reconnect kind of situations. I'm gonna go get a coffee. I desperately need it. I'll see you guys at the first job. So, we are at our first job for a modem offline. Found the problem immediately, which I hope is the only problem. In the basement, they have, I don't know if you can see it. Let's see, because I already lost sight of it. Right here. Conduit coming in from the line outside. All the conduit is PVC pipe. That comes underground, comes into their basement as their line. The splitter, their modem keeps going offline, kicking back on and going offline. The splitter was in this lovely pile. And this is what it looks like. So it's corroded and moldy. Not something I generally want to touch, but it's alright. We're going to cut it all off and put a new... check the levels and then put a new return pad on if we need one. Generally, they don't go in here, they go at the tap. So I don't really have a way to set this up, I don't think. But let's see if we can finagle something here. You know what? Set it right here. I'll try to. And if you guys can see what I'm doing, you can see what I'm doing. If not, too bad. I have to get this done. So we're gonna cut this off. And we're gonna cut this off because I'm not trying to touch any of this. Now, be mindful, what I just cut off is the input line. This is the line going upstairs. So if you put the input into the port that's not meant, like the output port, you're not gonna get any signal, you're probably gonna be racking your brain. So always pay attention. The customer this time was knowledgeable. She said yes, the line comes underground, which I could already tell because there's no poles here, at least none nearby. There's no aerial power. I saw the power meter in the front yard, so I just assessed that there was going to be an underground line here. The customer knew. Clearly they built this house, so they knew. This is an RG6 fitting right there, if you guys can see it. I still don't know if I set the camera up right. This goes on RG6 cable, and I dropped them all on the ground when I got out of the truck, so that's why I blew in there. You want to make sure your center conductor is not too long, because that can create ingress on your line as well. And when you're doing the fittings, I learned this day one. I was crimping them too tight and the plastic was popping off. I thought that was normal. It's not. You want to have it snug. You just don't want water or anything to get in there. Now, even the best crimp is going to not help the situation that we just had. Here's our input line. So what we're going to do is fix this and check our levels. So... get right to that in a second. Now this is the wire stripper. Clearly you can see me doing that, so it really doesn't need much of an explanation. But if we look at this line, it's all black, which means this may have to be re-ran. So we'll have to keep cutting back. Just means water and everything got in the line. So to expedite this process, cut off a lot more than usual. And it's gonna be looking like this line's unusable. It's kind of unfortunate. I don't know where this conduit goes to. So generally with our company, if we have to run through a conduit, it's chargeable. So, there we go, look at that. Nice. Now if we compare the two, where'd that one piece go? Oh boy. I shouldn't have chipped it. Here it is. I don't know if you'll be able to see that. This is all black. Means water got in the line, it's unusable. If you look at this, it's nice, clean copper. So we're going to cut it back to here, and we're going to use this. Cut about that much off. Slap a new fitting on it, and check the levels. So when you're doing this, even with RG11 cable, which is a thicker cable that we usually just use outside, and when we ground it, put it on a ground block or a barrel or a splitter, it's the same process. You want to peel this braid back. You want to make sure there's no plastic on your cable that will cause ingress. So put the fitting on here. Now whoever ran this, I don't know if they ran it themselves and we just hooked them up or not. Has to be grounded to power. I don't see a place to ground it in here. I don't see a ground cable. But I'm going to screw this in to this panel right here so it's not laying on the ground. Because that's why I got all moldy to begin with. Let's turn our meter on. Now another trick. It's not really a trick. Bring your meter in every single night. Don't leave it in your truck. Especially when it gets cold out, if you forget, you'll go to a job and your meter is going to be dead and you're going to be dead in the water. So always keep your meter charged. I'm going to run a Doxis, and I don't remember if I explained it in the last video. Doxis is going to tell me the levels coming out of the tap. We are technically at the ground block, so it's going to be from the tap to the ground block. There's a setting on my meter for each tap setting, ground block setting, and a CPE setting, which is customer equipment. Oh. We're going to use the ground block setting, because if I say we're at the customer's equipment and I did a one that was registering to the tap, it would give me a bunch of errors. Levels that are good would be in the red, so on and so forth. They would either be too high or too low. So we'll let that run and I'll get back with you guys in a second. Alright guys, so thankfully the line is still usable. They're at about a 9.6 over 36.3. Everything looks about even on both sides. I'm going to put them on a terminated three-way. The terminators are to reduce ingress. If you have an open port, it will create ingress. Maybe not immediately, but over time it will. So we're going to go from this jumbled mess with a return pad, and it looks like an upstream trap only, or modem only trap, to this. So we're going to put the input on here and check the levels again off the 7 leg. And what the 7 leg is going to do is it's going to add 7 to the upstream, and it's going to take away 7 from the downstream. So instead of being right at about 10, we're going to get a little wiggle room, and they should be fine. So I will catch you guys in a bit. All right, guys, so we are out here helping a fellow technician. Line got taken down last night. And it wasn't put up properly, so we're helping Tyler. I forget his tech number, but it's pretty dangerous. I'm out here to frag for him because everyone just speeds through here. I'll probably end up getting clapped. Always have a safety vest so people can see regardless of it, if it's day or night. Have a flag or two, cones, men working sign. We're going to be going from that pole at where the tap is to that sub pole to the house. So I will get back with you guys a little later. So I'm on lunch right now. It's about 3:30.
Been here since 8. It's been a long day, to say the least. It's been a long day. I couldn't get too much footage of the houses that I worked at today. It's been cold and rainy and real disgusting out. So I figure now that I'm on lunch, it's a good teaching point that you'll have your days that you absolutely love and you'll have your days that you absolutely hate. The last job, second to last job I did before my lunch, I had to go for a trouble call of their TVs pixelating or not getting a signal. The phone would drop off, and they have a VoIP through us, so the phone's connected to the modem. And she said her internet was taking a while to load. So I went through into the basement. They had a great signal, both on channel check and on their DOCSIS. Again, DOCSIS is on the meter that you'll get. Depending on your company, there are different variations of the meter, but DOCSIS is DOCSIS, and it will tell you the signal coming out of the tap. They had a great signal at their ground block, they had a great signal at their equipment, and a great signal at the tap. So I changed a bunch of fittings, I removed an amplifier, and I removed an upstream only pad off of a splitter. It shouldn't be on the splitter. I don't know if you're going to have it at your company. We do. Don't put return pads on the splitter. It's put it at the tap where it's supposed to go. Took all that stuff off. It adjusted the levels a little bit because their upstream was kind of jumping a couple dB per bonded channel. You'll get into that on your own. That'd be one of the first things they probably teach you, is about your channels and how they bond. When it was all said and done, I swapped out the modem for a newer one. They had an older one. Told them after this is all said and done, they might need a new router. They had a Belkin that was about 10 years old. Even with that, though, after I switched out everything, the TVs looked great. Everything came back on. The internet loaded a lot faster for her on her cell phone, on her Wi-Fi. So I did everything that I could do to help them. And I think they're going to be set now. Line looked fine. Ingress passed. Everything was great. And then this last job, and a teachable moment here, is if you're not on the job yet, or you've been on the job and you haven't had this happen yet, you're not always going to be able to get access to areas that you need, especially if the homeowner obviously owns their home. You should have no problem getting the things done that you need done. Maybe they don't want you to drill, so you won't be able to drill, and it'll just be that. If you go to an apartment where somebody rents, then you need landlord consent to drill any holes, at least for our company. I don't know what if some of you guys go rogue out there and start drilling shit. But with our company, we need landlord consent to drill. If there's a locked off area that is only accessible by the landlord, we need the landlord to open it. If not, that is the end of your job. You do nothing. The same thing where, or you do everything that you can up until the point where you can't anymore. Like getting into, last job, the basement was locked. Needed the landlord. He didn't want to call the landlord, so we didn't do anything when I left. Swapped out his modem, changed some fittings. Even though his levels were fine, I was there for a high upstream. His upstream was perfect. So, you know, it is what it is. I did everything I could and I left. Alright, so since my lunch is almost up, I want to end this video on some inspirational jank. You know what I mean? You're going to have days that you love and days that you hate, just like with any job. So, do your best. If you have a bad day, just get through it and go home. Once you're home, unwind. I dropped a ladder today. I had to pound it back in so I could use it. It fell on my fucking head at one point. Like, it's been raining all day. I was soaking wet. I'm still wet. It wasn't a great day for me, but you know what? The day's almost over. I get to go home and relax, and everything that I've worked for so far is going to be home. So it's worth it at the end of the day. Then you're going to have days that you absolutely love that are easy. You know, trouble calls for old ladies needing a new remote or needing a new HDMI cable, or they have the channel on the wrong input. You're gonna have great days and you're gonna have terrible days. Stick through it. This is a great career to get into. It's like how being a mechanic was a great, and it still is a great career to be in. Technology is ever evolving, and it starts with installing internet. Internet is the, you know, biggest thing in the world. So do your best, try your hardest. And if you need help, ask for help. You know, it's as simple as that. So that's it for me, man. Field Tech 81. If you like the video, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys maybe tomorrow. We'll see how tomorrow goes. Hopefully it's not raining. It's terrible weather. Yeah. Well, another guy just pulling right up to my van here. All right, guys. Peace.